All student athletes face a variety of challenges during their academic lives. They feel the pressure to perform in the big game, worry about passing that dreaded chemistry test, and go through the same growing pains as their peers. Some of them, however, encounter more demanding challenges. Today on Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed, we will take a closer look at those challenges and witness how the student athletes thrive after overcoming such hurdles. Welcome to Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed. I'm Jamie Parker.
And I'm Billy Mecker. Today we're going to focus on the challenges faced by student athletes before, during, and after graduation.
And we'll also visit with the goalies of our hockey team to see the interesting situations they face before each game. We'll also catch up with the captain of the women's hockey team and get to know her a little better as she prepares for graduation.
But first, we're going to visit with a member of the men's basketball team whose rough journey before Quinnipiac has made him stronger and better than ever.
My mother met this guy. I don't know how, he just came to the house one night. I realized like he was abusive. And then once I turned 13, then this incident happened where him and my mom was fighting and I was in the next bedroom. And then my mom just went in my room and told all of us that we're leaving, we're going to the shelter. So pack everything. And I'm just leaving and go to a place I don't even know about, and I heard stories that it wasn't a good place to stay.
I kind of found out that, and this really hurt me, I found out that he couldn't eat, not because he didn't want to eat, because there was no food.
But one apartment was the worst because it was just one room combined with the kitchen, and there was a room for the bathroom, and that was it. So like, it was hard.
There were so many things thrown in front of this kid that he could have tripped and just said, "What the heck with it?" Life is throwing me so many curveballs. You know, I just can't hit him anymore. And it was never my, in my dealings with him, he never had that feeling that I'm gonna quit. I'm gonna give up.
It's a combination between my mom's teaching me the right way, and just I don't know how to explain it. It's just me. Like my personality, my character is not to complain, is to stay humble, stay positive for whatever's going on, because at the end of the day, it's going to be all right.
That positive attitude caught the attention of others, especially one very remarkable teacher.
It just so happened I had some donuts, and he was staring at them. So I said that I wouldn't tutor him until he ate a donut. So he ate one. But he was hungry, and I'm a parent. I know when a kid's hungry.
She got into this routine of just keep bringing me food. Like, it became snacks, and then it became like home-cooked meals that she would cook the day before for our family.
Is this a kid who had no excuses? He came, did his work, did his classwork, and then when people found out that he had every reason to come up with excuses, people just really just started embracing this kid.
Marquise then began to think about that important next step, life after high school.
And he would say to me, "I want to go to college." In the early stages, he thought it was impossible.
I had to get tutoring for SATs and all that.
What was great about the tutoring is he wanted the tutoring.
This child, he would study constantly. When it came time for the SATs, he was studying for the SATs on the MTA.
You just stay positive and stick to school, not give up, and just have a good mind, good mindset on everything.
Not only was Marquise doing well in school, his star on the court began to shine as well.
I think as a head coach, my excitement level was a little higher for him because I knew his background and his past. And, I think any kid who had to overcome what he had to overcome, there's had to be something deep inside him that really was good and was really strong.
You just knew he was tough. Marquise's game is based on his toughness and his strength. He competes, he tries, he doesn't take plays off.
I just want to give to my team to make my team happy, positive way. Whatever it takes to win, I'll do it.
We had a deep conversation just between me and him about, you know, family and stuff, and it came up, and he told me, and I was, you know, I was shocked to see that somebody like him actually went through something like that, and is here now playing basketball and so focused.
He's just happy to be doing things with other people that he cares about, and we're happy to have him around because we care about him.
It's obvious many do care for Marquise, but it's his amazing spirit that has touched those around him.
I've been teaching a long time, very long time, but none like Marquise. You meet a kid like this once in a lifetime.
Having that type of kid, just because he's a good kid, not because he was homeless or he had a rough life, just because he's a good person.
He's got a quiet confidence about him and a quiet presence about him that I think everybody on the team likes and respects.
I just want to give back to like the shelters and like get back to the community where I grew up at, because it's still rough over there. Like, I have a couple of friends that live over there still, and it's just rough. So like, I just want to give back.
He's destined to be successful. Basketball. Can he always play basketball? Sure. And will he play or maybe teach others or maybe someday his own child? Yes.
It's going to be amazing to me, probably even more so when it's his turn to be a dad. And you know, who knows how long from now. And be able to teach the lessons that he learned before he got here, while he was here, certainly when he leaves, to the next generation of Barnetts. That's the most important thing of all.
Wow, what a moving story, Billy.
You know, Jamie, life isn't so much about holding a good hand, it's about playing a poor hand well. It's really going to be nice to watch Marquise's growth during his time here at Quinnipiac.
It certainly is. All right, when we return, we're going to take a look at corporate naming in college athletics and the sometimes precarious role of the college hockey goalie. Stay tuned. Hello, and welcome back to Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed. You know, Billy, the college hockey goaltender is a little bit of a different breed compared to the typical ice player.
And their pregame rituals are legendary to help them get into the zone. Bill Schweitzer caught up with the Quinnipiac goalies to better understand how they prepare for a game.
Thanks, Jamie and Billy. You know, it takes a certain kind of person to be a goaltender in hockey at any level, and the ECAC is no exception. Now, recently I caught up with two of the Quinnipiac goaltenders, Eric Hartzell for the men's team, Vicky Vigilante for the women's team, and I wanted to know, how the heck do you keep the puck out of the net?
When I was young, I was on my dad's hockey team, and we didn't have a goalie, and he shoved me in the net, and I let in 8 goals. I think I made 1 save, and from then on, I just had it was like a spark, like I loved it.
You know, it's kind of a weird position, you know, you just try it once, and if you like it, you like it, if you don't, you hate it.
And you have to be a special breed to be a goalie. So I guess I was that breed from the get-go, and I just loved it.
You know, they're in a tough spot out there with pucks getting zipped at them at 95 miles an hour. You got to have, got to be a little off center a little bit to want to play the position.
Yeah, there's definitely pros and cons to being a goalie, and like I said, there are going to be times where you're letting that goal in overtime, or you let that third period goal in. It's a bummer, but it's also awesome when you're in overtime or you're in that third period and you make a big save.
A goalie, I mean, you make a mistake, and you make 2 mistakes right off the bat, you're down 2-0. And, you know, you're starting the game, you're in that crease, you're responsible for either a smooth start and hopefully a great end to a game.
And it's so worth it to have that feeling at the end of the game, knowing that you were a big contributor to the win and to the great season.
Goal first period to a 4-2 win.
Goalies are so peculiar in how they, you know, they approach games and their whole, they've all got rituals.
You know, she has so many little idiosyncrasies and things, routines she goes through. I can't keep up and I don't bother.
Well, they're a little bit nuts, there's no question about it. I mean, think about it. Anybody wants to stop that hard black rubber thing like that, you got to be a little crazy to start with.
I mean, a lot of guys will sit there and chit-chat and stuff. I'll have my headphones on the entire time. I'll have, I'll juggle with the balls. And with all that going on, 3 balls in the air at one time, it helps keep your mind focused on the exact next task at hand. So when the ball's coming down at your hand, you're not focused on the other 2 balls in the air, but you're focused on that one.
We play keep-ups. We have a soccer ball, and there's like a keep-up team that we have, about 6 or 7 girls, and we stand there and just play soccer. Keep-ups, kicking it back and forth. Our record is 60 right now, so each game we try and break our record and continue going on. It's very competitive.
So it's good to keep your mind going like that, and it really does it really does help train the brain to stay focused and calm at the same time.
Whenever I watch him doing it, I guess sometimes I gotta refocus and get away from him because it's pretty mesmerizing. He's pretty good.
I like the attention. I love being in the spotlight. I love the pressure that a goaltender has to have and has to deal with.
You know, if a goalie does make a mistake, the puck normally ends up in the back of the net. And I kind of like that pressure and responsibility, so it's fun to have that.
But it's a tough position, and you know, certainly, you know, as far as the world of sports go, not just hockey, you know, maybe the goaltender in hockey can dominate a sport as much as anyone.
A normal person wouldn't know the feeling. I couldn't even explain it to you guys. It's just a whole thing off your shoulder. You make that big save and you're on cloud nine. Like, you can't really explain it in words. You just know you did your job, and there's a smile on your face for the next week until the next game.
You know, the rituals they go through are mind-boggling, but the focus is clear. Keep the puck out of the net. Jamie and Billy?
Well, while goaltenders are focused on protecting their net, many business organizations are focused on promoting the good name of their company through college athletics.
And I had a chance to take a look at why both companies and universities love this form of teamwork.
First of all, we're thrilled to be a sponsor of the athletic program. And it does a couple of things for us right off the bat. It allows us to support the university in our marketplace, which we want to do.
And having great corporate partners like TD Bank and High Point Solutions and Lender Court really just helps us have national recognition for both our teams, our student athletes, and our coaches.
It just adds to everything that the university, our program, and puts it in a position, continues to put it in a position of national prominence.
We wanted to be a part of an environment that had a positive vibe, an energy level, a university that's going places.
You know, undoubtedly the growth of the school, you know, over the last few years, as far as many of the schools in this area, they've probably gone under the greatest change and the greatest positive change.
The association is very important, and we take it real seriously. We want to do right by everyone and make sure Quinnipiac is achieving its mission and being a good corporate citizen. But we also have responsibility with these individuals and companies that have associated their name with Quinnipiac.
And that association provides for some enjoyable moments at the University Club in the TD Bank Sports Center.
This specific sports center is very different. It's very, very important to the area. It's very nice. It makes a great statement. And so to put our name on it means a lot.
It's a great place for them to entertain. It's a great place for them to showcase their brand linked with a quality academic brand.
Getting involved in the athletic program, the new facility, the varsity club, when we bring our clients here, it's a first-class experience.
But here with a venue like this, we invite the governor. He comes and has dinner and watches the game. And literally, I sat next to him and talked with him about a variety of things, and obviously mentioned Quinnipiac a few times here and there for three solid hours.
People have asked about Quinnipiac now with the medical school coming.
Well, here we are again, the newest medical school in the country, now the most famous name, the Frank Netter School of Medicine at Quinnipiac University.
It's the place to be, and business people want to be around an environment that is going places.
So when we look at these sorts of opportunities, we're also looking for the quality of the institution or the entity that we're trying to support. And part of that is aligning ourselves with the right groups of people doing the right things, and Quinnipiac has been that for us.